Hey guys, it's Dabs. Welcome to my YouTube channel. I am excited to have you join me in this tutorial. As usual, I'm continuing my cloning tutorials. This tool here called Fignel has a Figma plugin that promises to help us bridge the gap between Figma designs and Elementor. So basically, you can convert your Figma designs to Elementor easily using this plugin. If this would work, this will significantly improve the workflow of any UI UX designer. So I just want to test out this tool. I want to see exactly what it can do. I just got on board on this tool. I got access to the free version of it. I have the API sent to my email, so I want us to check out the result we are going to get with this. So now let's check out this tool. Let's go to Figma. In this tutorial, I want to see exactly how we can literally just pick a random design online, and then we can convert it to Figma design. We can redesign in Figma, and then we can export to Elementor. So for the purpose of this example, I want us to experiment with WordPress.org. As usual, this is a disclaimer. I'm not encouraging you to clone WordPress.org or anybody's website online. I'm only showing this tutorial for educational purposes alone. So now let's copy WordPress.org. Let's come back into Figma. So I have a project here. First of all, to clone that page, we just need to use the help of a plugin. So if you have been following my tutorials, you should know that plugin by now. It is called HTML to design. Here is HTML to design. In your own case, if you come here, you have not used that plugin before. If you come to plugins here, you can just come to manage plugin and then search for that plugin. It's a freemium plugin. You can use it for free for a limited project. So if you want to use it more, you should consider going pro. So I would plug in the URL wordpress.org here. And then we have the option here to choose a viewpoint. So we can choose whether or not we want to have a 1920, which is a desktop, a laptop, a tablet, a phablet, and a mobile. But let's just keep this as just laptop view alone. This is for experimental purpose. Another thing we must do is to make sure that we keep this as auto layout. Very important. So once this is done, I can just close this and then I can hit the import button. Awesome, this plugin has done its job and this is done. So let's close this plugin. So we have a cloned version of that URL here, and this is literally super simple and easy. So let's zoom this to fit and let's see. So you can see this is literally wordpress.org here. This is how super simple it is for you to just easily clone any website and then you can use it for your project. So right now I can just choose to zoom this a little bit more, and then I can play around in Figma, try to redesign this, change some text, change some images, customize this to suit what I want to do exactly with it. So now that we have this design here, let's use the help of this plugin called Fignel to see if we can really truly export this to Elementor. So now let's come back here as usual. Let's come to our plugins and then let's come to Fignel. If you don't have it, you can search for it as usual. And if you are here, you need to maybe start a free trial or just go to their website. I went to their website, created a free account, and then I had an email from there that gave me an activation code literally for free. This is not a paid plan. This is a free plan. So you can do the same thing too as well. So right now we have this plugin launched, as you can see. So it's saying that select a frame to start converting a design. So now let's just pick this frame. So we've recognized this section here. So let's download Elementor template. So let's see exactly what this can do. So it's saying that we need to make, we need to activate our Flexbox container in our website. So we will get to that eventually. So let's wait for this to finish up. All right. So we have this download complete here. So we can see here we have a JSON file here. So now let's come to our website here. So this is a default WordPress website. So if we come to the back end here, you can see that I've just installed Elementor. So it says that let's come to settings. Coming to features here and scrolling down, we can see the Flexbox container is turned on, is active. Well, we can just ensure that it is active. So let's just come and to a page here. Let's try to create a new page. I'll call this tabs tutorial. And then I can publish it. I love to publish my page first, and then I can edit this with Elementor. Okay, so let's close this up. All right, so okay, let's close this navigator, and then let's come here. Let's come to template. All right, so we can upload our JSON file. So let's come here and let's just drag this here. Yes, continue. Okay, so now you can see that we have our template here. So what we can now do is to insert this and yes, apply this. Okay, so we have this import successful. So we can see not good things here already. Let me just close this. All right, so I think we have issues with the menu here. Basically, I think the menu here is what we have issues with. So that's why this here too is not aligning properly. And we can see that we have some alignment issues here too as well. This one seems to be perfect. This one seems to be perfect as well. This one seems to be good, good, good. Some alignment issues here too as well. Generally, I think this is a good try. I believe this has a lot of potential. This would definitely increase your workflow because this is already Elementor here. We can take this element away and then redesign the element. Okay, so right now, we can just choose to delete some of the element or rework some of the element based on whatever we feel is right for us. A lot of reworking can be done here, basically, but I think just doing an update here right now and then viewing this page will suffice for this tutorial. All right, so let's view this page and let's see. All right, so you can see menu's gone. Some of the elements here are still not aligning. We could just reduce the sizes and realign them by ourselves. So far, so good. This is not a bad clone. This is not a very bad clone. And this is good. Just a little bit of tweaking, reworking, a little bit of redesigning some things possibly also inside Figma, and then we can have this all put together. So basically you can just pick up any landing page and then you can redesign them in Figma and then have them as Elementor pages. You can just continue with that tool, clone other pages of the website. So for instance, we can come back here, we can go to the about page, and then we can do the same process for every of the pages. So that's exactly how this work. If you find this video useful, give me a thumbs up. You can go experiment with this. This might just work out for you. So that's it. I'll see you in another tutorial, and until then, have a nice time. Bye for now.